Okay, so in learning the G major scale, it's very important to know the note that makes up the G major scale. And making up the G major scale, we have the G note, we have the A note, we have the B note, we have the C note, we have the D note, we have the E note, we have the F sharp note, and we have the G note. Those are the eight notes that makes up the G major diatonic scale. The G major diatonic scale, I'll go over it again, is your open G string, then your first finger on your G string, that's your A note, then your second finger, let's say the proximity, the interval difference, that's your B note, then your C note is close to your B note, it's a semitone movement, then your D note, then your E note, then your F sharp note, then your G note. So it's very important that you know that the G major scale has an interval arrangement. So you have the G to A as a full tone, the A to B as a full tone, the B to C as a semitone, the C to D as a full tone, the D to E as a full tone, the E to F sharp as a full tone, and then the F sharp to G as a semitone. So show you again over on the violin. The G to A is a full tone. The G to A is a full tone. The A to B is a full tone. The B to C is a semitone. That is why they are close together. The C to D, assumptively, you know the C to D is a full tone, but because we're playing the D on the full string, it's also still a full tone. And the D to E is also a full tone. And the D E, the E note to F sharp is also a full tone. And then a full tone from the F sharp to G is a semitone. So I hope you understand and how to run your scale on the G major scale. You learn to run it on the ascending order and also on the descending order. So you go to your first finger, that's your A, then your second B, then your third C, then your fourth D, then your fifth E, then your sixth F sharp, then your seventh. It's actually eight because you start with the Do as a G and you end with G. So it's first octave, the same musical rudiment applies to it, so you go on the second octave. That's an ascending, you come back on the D and F sharp, then your E, then your So it's very important that when you rehearse with the metronome. So you have a count, and I have a metronome here on my phone. So I have a tuner that helps me with the metronome use. So I'm just going to play a metronome for us so that we could have it with our rehearsers here. So this is how the metronome works. So you could set the metronome count in order to aid your effective rehearsers. So it goes this way, so I could start with 50. We start with the metronome 50 for a start. So you without metronome for a start, here we go. And also you could choose the note value you want to work with. If you want to work with the crotchet note value, or you want to work with the minim note value, that is it. A single count, a 1 beat, or a 2 beat. So you could go, with the minim, the 2 beat per note, 2 beat per note, so 2 beat per note. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Two. in this way you could effectively increase your pace, and remember to always first seek precision, accuracy before you find speed on the violin. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Please like and subscribe to this channel so you will always get more violin songs and tutorials coming your way. Thank you.